Right now, if you look at the scientific literature on the nature of reality, you will come across something called the simulation hypothesis. And this simulation hypothesis suggests that you and I and the universe are part of a virtual reality or a simulation. And that we are dream characters in a collective dreamscape. Now, this is an old idea, Maya. Maya is the illusion, the goddess of illusion, and Leela is the play of consciousness. But our current scientists are not there yet. And they do suggest, some of them, that the universe is a virtual reality. And this hypothesis was first proposed by philosopher Nick Bostrom in 2003, I believe. And Bostrom argues that if advanced civilizations are able to create simulated realities, then it is likely that we are living in one. This is because the number of simulated realities that could be created by advanced civilizations is vastly greater than the number of real universes. There are several arguments in favor of this hypothesis, which is called simulation hypothesis. One argument is that the laws of physics seem to be fine-tuned for mind and life. This means that the constants of nature, such as the speed of light and the gravitational constant, are just the right for the existence of life. This is a very unlikely coincidence if the universe is real, but it is not unlikely if the universe is a simulation. Another argument in favor of the simulation hypothesis is that the universe seems to be computationally feasible to simulate. So we can simulate the universe. If we assume that the universe is a computer simulation, then the amount of computing power required to simulate it would be equal to the amount of energy in the universe. This is a large amount of energy, but it is not impossible to achieve. So these are some of the ideas that are being proposed. And if you want to know my opinion, I think people are getting close to it, but they are not actually there. They're getting close to it, they're not actually there. So, I would like to actually give an alternative explanation. And that is also part of a mainstream discussion right now. The universe looks more like a big thought than a big machine. That's a quote from The Mysterious Universe by British astronomer and mathematician James Jeans, Sir James Jeans. And that book was published as early as 1930 and explores the philosophical implications of modern physics. James was fascinated by the order and regularity of the universe, and he argued that it was more likely to be the product of a mind than of a random process. Here I quote from James Jeans: "The universe begins to look more and more like a great thought rather than a great machine. Mind no longer appears to be an accidental intruder into the realm of matter, but rather its creator and governor." Sir James Jeans' quote reflects the growing awareness in the early 20th century that the laws of physics are not as deterministic as once thought. Quantum mechanics, in particular, showed that there is an element of unpredictability in the universe. This led some physicists to believe that the universe could not have arisen by chance, but must have been created by a mind. James Jeans' quote is still relevant today as physicists continue to grapple with the mystery of the universe. The more we learn about the universe, the more it seems to resemble a vast and complex thought rather than a simple machine. This raises the question of whether there is a mind behind the universe and whether it is simply a product of chance. In recent years, there's been a growing interest in the field of quantum consciousness, which explores the possibility that consciousness is an essential property of the universe. If this is true, then Sir James Jean's quote could be seen as a prescient statement of the nature of reality. Now, all this is very recent, but my friends, it is part of the ancient tradition of Vedanta that there is an infinite realm of existence, which is infinite possibilities, superposition of all possibilities, where the laws of quantum mechanics apply, and this infinite entity, being infinite, is capable of projecting infinite universes, and it does so through its own self-interaction. And this now is being supported by string theories, multiverse theories. But I think if you're not averse to using spiritual terms, all these universes are springing forth from one consciousness, from one mind. And we can call it the divine mind, or God, or Allah, or Brahman, or Ein Sof, or It, or the unified field, or the conscious energy field. Doesn't matter what we call it, but we are part of God's stream. Simple. All these theories are accommodated if you understand that you and I are a flickering dream in the one mind. Let me know what you think.